Hey there. Said that either today or tomorrow would be Tales Day, and turns out that today is that day, as tomorrow has turned into a different stream, so today's gonna be this. Where the heck was I? Right, I was right outside of- okay, yes. I was doing stuff in Mercio. Okay. Last time we did a pretty dang cool side quest with, Aizen and, Phoenix. That was probably the coolest thing. And then we're also on the hunt for a Zavied side quest, and we did one with Eleanor, where she, channeled the spirit of Velvet for a little bit, getting revenge for her town. But yeah. Let me... Oh, right, I was gonna say, well, I was in here for a reason. Expedition.
Take a look at this.
Show us your determination.
Sweet. Triple win. Come on.
Well.
Mythic egg.
Good luck, Al.
Nope. All right. We still have this to get in Albane, so we'll be getting there. And let's hydrate. This was on Monday. It was about 2 hours long. It was not a very long stream. And I'm actually a little bit behind on the backlog of uploading to YouTube, because I like to just upload like a video or two a day. So I'm gonna have to like jump the queue for Berseria is probably what I'll do. I'll just jump the queue and throw them both up tomorrow. This one and last week's, or not last week's, but Monday's. So, but basically what you missed was a really nifty side quest with Aizen, that involves his sister, and a side quest with Eleanor. That we got forced into with we could not back out no matter what. There was no way of leaving that quest. So now we're in Mercio. We're currently hunting Zavied, or like the dragon that Zavied is protecting, who is his wife, I guess. Anyway, let's head into the inn. I know there were a couple leaves to do. Hey, doggy. Well, hi, doggy.
Grimoire, could we talk?
You sound so serious, like it's the eve of the final battle.
Well, isn't it? Can't you let yourself get caught up in the moment for a change?
Getting caught up in the moment is for young, foolhardy lovers. So, what is it you want to talk about?
I just figured I should drop by since, well, like I said, the final battle with the Nominat is coming up and all.
Ugh, you're talking like you're saying your last goodbyes.
It's just that we're up against a lot. Even Miss Mogilu doesn't know what the future holds for us, and she almost always has that stuff figured out.
Whether she has it figured out or not, it is our lot in life to follow our vessels and fight to the very end.
That's what I've always thought, so I just dealt with Miss Mogilu's craziness up till now. But she's never thanked me for it. No, good job, Bienfu. No, I'm glad I'm your vessel. Not even something like, I'll introduce you to a cute girl when it's all over. It'd be nice to hear a little gratitude from her, even just once.
Surely you know she's not the type to do that sort of thing, though, yes?
That's all the more reason to want just one brief glimpse at who she is underneath.
If you're so unhappy, it's not too late to switch back to the Abbey's side and become an informant again.
What's the point in that? I don't know anything they'd want, and they wouldn't have any use for me there.
So you lack confidence in your own abilities.
Miss Mogilu has let me come with her wherever she went, and her talents have gotten us this far. But now that we have to fight Inominat, I'm worried. I don't know what use I could be for her, or if I can keep her safe.
But you'll still go, won't you?
Yeah, of course! Or else my name isn't Norman Brave!
See, you can do this. You've been keeping Moggy Lou safe this whole time. With all the emotional pain she's been through, she's needed someone as thick-skinned and tenacious as you. She may talk like she doesn't care, but she wouldn't have tracked you down and renewed your pact if she didn't.
When you put it like that, bien! All right, you've convinced me!
That's right. You just trust in old Norman therapist's good advice. It won't steer you wrong.
Wow! I'd have never expected you to actually make a joke like that, Grimoire!
I just thought I'd get caught up in the moment like you wanted.
Ah, Norman name jokes. Well, good on you, Bianfu, for helping us out and not turning. Dogs hanging out by the fire. I think there's one in here as well. Oh, yeah, there is.
Kamuana, has your fever finally gone down?
It has, and it's all thanks to you.
But now there's something extremely important that she must ask of you. Would you hear her out?
You sound really serious. What is it?
I want you to open my treasure chest with me.
A treasure chest? What's inside?
Well...
treasure, of course. So it's a secret.
But it's a really, really, really important treasure!
How important are we talking here? Would you risk your own life for it?
I totally would! It's at least that important! Maybe more!
Well, if it's that important, then I guess we'll have to help you.
Yay! Thank you.
Where's the treasure chest, then?
On some ice? Floating out in the sea?
Next time, you should probably leave it somewhere a little safer, Kamuana.
Oh! And you can't open it without the key.
This is getting more complicated by the second.
Well, if you leave a treasure chest unlocked, you're just asking for trouble.
Okay. You've got me there.
Do you remember where the key is?
It's in Dial's pocket. I slipped it in while he was sleeping.
Yeah, I don't like where this is going.
What else was I supposed to do? It's a secret key!
Yeah, I know.
All right, let's go hunt down Dial. Good luck!
Zambo, it's all been side quest stuff. The stuff from Monday's stream is basically self-contained from the stuff from today, so... the quick of it is, there was a Aizen side quest that was really cool and had a boss, and then there was an Eleanor side quest that we got basically roped into. So, Kamuana, I guess, has learned the ways of the pirate and has hidden... alright. We're just gonna go steal a key from Dial. Hey, Dial, where are you at? Okay, so I think the church had a couple things, so I'm gonna go upstairs to that. Well, the church slash forge that Kurogane was making use of. Oh, hey. Nice hat. That's a really big hat on you.
Mogilu's real name is Mogilonica, isn't it? Yes, it is. She's always been so distant.
Distant? What makes you say that?
She's always had strong resonance and was able to see us Malakim from the day she was born.
But her family thought her powers were creepy, and they abandoned her while she was still just an infant.
That's terrible.
So she got picked up by that crooked troop that put her in their freak show.
Yeah, that was when she caught me. When I got caught up in her life.
It's hard to imagine how painful it must have been. A little girl forced to the stage, made a source of amusement and revulsion and hate. You can see why she'd want someone on her side, even if that someone was Bianfu.
Hey!
But she managed to get away, right? After the accident?
Well, that accident was set up by Lord Melchior.
What?
Is it so hard to believe? Melchior was looking for someone he could shape into becoming his worthy successor, so he made sure she survived the wreck.
He probably justified it as saving the world.
Tell me, Grimoire, what's your connection with Melchior?
I don't really have one. I knew the former head of the Exorcist a little, but I stayed out of his way. He never talked about personal matters. At least not while he was sober.
As I recall, Mogulu trained under Melchior, and rose as far up the ranks as Legate.
That's right! She worked really, really hard to get there, too!
Mogulonica Lou Maven. When Melchior adopted her and gave her his last name, that was the first time she really felt that she had a home. When she lost that name, she was devastated.
She failed Lord Melchior's last test, and he just discarded her like an unwanted toy!
She was an empty shell of a person when Bienfu brought her to me. Mogilu stayed with me for a little while, but then one day she left without warning. As for what happened next, well, you probably know better than I do.
Yeah, I guess we do.
I'd ask you to look after her, but I know how that would go.
It'd have to be a pretty cold day in hell.
I'm sorry I talked about your past behind your back. It wasn't my place to say.
It doesn't bother me. You were talking about Mogulonica, and Mogulonica might as well be dead.
But while we're on the subject, may I ask just one question? It wasn't failing to hold up against Melchior's art that broke your spirit, was it? It was when you realized that he no longer considered you his daughter.
Who can say? I've left my life as Mogulonica behind me. I'm not her anymore. I'm the evil witch Mogilu who fights alongside the Lord of Calamity!
Well, wherever you go, Miss Mogilu, I'll follow you as long as I live!
Well now, Bienfu, you think you can get away with talking about me behind my back?
Huh? Why do you only care that I did it? What about the others?
Yours is not to question!
How could I forget how mean you are?
I'm glad you finally found a place where you can belong.
Oh! Ooh! Color variant. Oh boy. What do we got? I like fashion. Alright. And this is like one of the few outfits I would change up. So we have reversed black and red. The hat is still pink. Can we work with this? Also, the books are now green and black rather than brown and white. Wish the hat changed. That's actually a bit of a sad thing here. I kind of wish the hat brim changed up. Like, is that a... Oh, okay, I have to switch the hat manually. Okay. Oh, that's better. Okay, that actually... I'm gonna move off the eyebrows. Let's move those off. What do we want? What do we got? What do we want here? Well, that was more like putting together all the information we already had at this point, you know? Like, that was sort of like, we had that sort of like... figure, like, we knew some of that stuff, so... She's not color coordinated with Rapide. It's okay. I like the hat as a black and white with a red brim. That's pretty good. Well, it's black and white and red all over. Nuclear type. Pirate brooch, servant's tie. I had the fake mustache for a while. No, we already established I don't want eye. Like, anything that covers her eyes is wrong. Ears aren't wrong. Hubert's glasses actually look just fine. They don't have the overhead, they only have the under, which Aizen's only have the over, I think, is the difference. Also, like, disco earring. I'm gonna switch back to disco earring for now. I think disco earring is 125% disco earring. I call it disco earring, but it's not actually that disco. It's pretty disco, to be honest. Alright.
Shall we be?
And we got another one to do over here.
If you repent your sins in a sanctuary, the Empyreans are supposed to forgive you or something, right? If I say something here, I wonder if Enominat will hear me.
I don't think it works like that. Besides, I doubt this sanctuary was built on an Earth Pulse point.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Was there something you wanted to say to him?
Yeah. I wanted to thank him for the comb, and also tell him what I'll be doing next.
If I had to guess, I'd say that everything you want to say has already made it over to Laffy.
Why do you think that?
Because I got it loud and clear myself.
Fee.
Malakim turned people's prayers into blessings. What you pray here and now may or may not reach Enominat. But it will give Lafayette strength.
All right. Then I'll pray for just one thing. Please, take care of...
Please help me, my family is dying. All right. Cat soul, we're at 750. So let me check up. I don't think there's any. Nope. We have to go. I think Dial's actually in town. So let's go steal the key from Dial. We'll do that quick. And then from there, we have to go find Zavied. Well, not Theodora, actually, but Zavied will likely be there as well. Hey, Dial. I need to steal from you. Alright, stealth.
Why the hell did I have to be an old lizard? Why couldn't I be a salamander? Then at least I could breathe fire to warm myself up!
Don't move, Dial. We're going to search you now.
What? Why? I haven't done anything wrong! Today.
No key.
Figures. You must have dropped it somewhere.
What are you all talking about?
Kamuana says she hid the key to her treasure chest in your pocket.
Seriously? Why me?
I just figured that if anybody tried to steal it, you'd, like, bite them and stuff to protect it.
I'm sorry I didn't live up to your expectations.
Any idea where you might have dropped it?
That's hard to say. Wait, it might have been when I was drying my shirt back in the inn. I think I heard a clink of some sort there.
Wait, when it was drying? Don't you know to check your pockets before you do the wash?
Come on, I'm a bachelor! You're expecting way too much from me.
Well, I guess we should check the inn next.
Got it.
Alright, let's go check out the inn and see if we can find it in, near, like, the dryer? They don't have a washer dryer, that's too advanced. I will always leave, like, a D20 in my pocket. Like, I forget them constantly. Not a coin or something normal. No, it's always a dice.
There it is! This must be the key!
Yay! You found it! I knew you could do it, Eleanor!
You said the chest was floating on an iceberg, right? I'd say that's our next stop.
You hold on to the key, Kamuana. Just make sure you don't drop it, okay?
Okay.
Alright, now we have to find a treasure on an iceberg. Is that in town? Yeah, way out here. Down these a bonfire.
It opened! It opened!
Good job, Kamawana!
Alright, so what's inside?
Don't you remember? It's supposed to be a secret.
It's one of my mom's recipes. She wrote it down for me so that I could fix it myself when I got older.
That sounds like something really precious. Are you sure you want to share it with us?
Uh-huh. It's supposed to be a secret between me and my mom, but you all saved me when I needed you, and I really want to thank you, so it's okay. Thanks, everyone.
You're welcome, Kamawana.
It's a recipe for Mabo curry that my mom came up with just for me. It's the best in the whole wide world!
It looks delicious!
You better have some too, Velvet. You go out there and win! Medissa and me will be cheering you on!
Yeah, I won't back down. I promise.
Oh! Whoa, wait, Mabo Curry Bun! Hey, I know that recipe. I use that one a lot. Is it the Yeah. Oh, I need a legendary tofu? Since mixing Mabo and curry wasn't enough, this is the next step in culinary evolution. I used Mabo Curry Bun as, like, my thing to eat in Zestiria a lot. It was a pretty damn good one. Let's go to the Wyvern Tendon Stew.
Done. If you like it, I can make it again.
Alright, I think that's everything in town. Let's... Yep. Looks right. Alright, let's quick... we want to go... Let's just check Kill Arouse. Area map is this, and nothing. Nothing, nothing. Nothing at the summit. Okay. So we actually want to go out the way we came. Oh, dogs are back! Hey, dogs. Yes, weren't Mabo curry buns things characters made a big deal about in Zestiria? Yeah. They definitely were. They were also a pretty good thing to eat at inns. Metal Gear. Mabo Curry Bun. Colonel. This thing's delicious. Alright. So, actually, it's the other side. Right, I actually remember this. Yeah, it's over on the other side of town. And also, I have a cat's chest to go grab, so let's go do that. Do-do-do. Whatever, I got some cat souls, so it wasn't a waste. Anytime I get more cat souls, it's not a waste at all. It was a good use of time. Hey, Dial. Thanks, Dial. Alright. Yeah, so it's back the way we came, basically. Well, not the way we came, but back to the... like, south and around here, which will be fine. Alright. I got a feeling this one's gonna be pretty good. Again, Zavied has been pretty strong in this game as far as a character goes. And this is one I'm pretty invested in. Yep, see him.
She's hurt, just like they said. Is this really how you mean to lift your curse?
I'm not the cursed one.
I'm game.
Let's go.
I told you, that ain't happening on my watch.
And if you stop me?
What else? I'm going to figure out a way to save her.
If that's what you want to try, then go ahead. But know that I'm not going to stop.
You know, I just don't get it. How could a guy like Ifrit be friends with someone so hellbent on senseless killing?
Sometimes, to kill someone is to save them.
Who the hell is going to be saved by being killed? There's not one damn person in the whole world! No matter what happens, you can't give up on living. That's my creed.
Well then.
Guess we're doing this.
What? Why does it have to come to this? You both want to save the same person!
Sometimes, you just have to fight these things out.
Yeah.
Hell yeah!
I ain't holding back, Aizen. Good.
Zavied's theme rules.
Then fight to kill.
Now, rise!
Zavied's theme is incredible.
What?
Ooh, I got stunned on that. That's bad. Okay. What are your weaknesses? None. Okay. Oh, God. Super stunned. Yeah, Zavied still has the Chaos Emerald. Yep. Yep, Chaos Emeralds. But yeah, Zavied's theme is extremely good. It's one of my favorite pieces in the game. It's straight from his theme from Zestiria too, so.
No mercy! You thought I'd stop there. Annihilated? Dear police! You broke me! Here's your justice! Fighting order! Kirika! Rizal! Arise! Become the blade of destruction! Lost
on! Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try!
Threat.
You got that right.
Don't even try it.
Zavied, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm not dead yet, at least.
Thank you for saving me.
I should be thanking you. I'm just glad you're not hurt.
Me?
That's right, kid. Nothing would hurt Theodora more than to harm a child.
Theodora.
The thing is, even when a child's lost their parents, their family, even when despair fills their heart, if you hold their hand, they'll squeeze back. Those hands, frozen cold from fear and insecurity, will start to feel warmth again. That warmth, a tiny spark deep within, can rekindle their feeling of being alive, because they possess the determination to keep on living. That's why Theodora never turned her back or gave up on a child. She was more passionate about life
than anyone I've ever known.
And that's why you're protecting her.
Just how long do you plan on cleaning up after that dragon?
She's Theodora.
Once a Moloch becomes a dragon, there's no turning back.
And you think that gives you the right to kill her? You talk like you have such noble intentions, but you're not fooling anyone. You just want to lift your Reaper's curse.
I'm not the one who's cursed.
You're telling me there's some other Reaper out there?
Don't answer a question with another question.
Shut the hell up! You're all talk and no fight. You're a damn coward. That's all you are. In the future, if you try to lay even a finger on Theodora, well, there's going to be hell to pay.
Give me hell if you like, but think about one thing first. Think about what she taught you about living, and consider what it really means to be alive.
Why does it have to be like this? I get that their creeds mean a lot to them both, but isn't that all the more reason for them to try to understand each other? But instead, they resort to fighting without even listening to each other first. How can they be like this?
Yeah, I don't want them to fight either. But there's something else I can't figure out.
Is it about why Aizen's so intent on killing that dragon?
That's part of it. What I can't figure out is what he means when he says that killing can also save someone. And how he's not the one with the curse.
Maybe he feels pity for Theodora, and how she's doomed to keep on living as a dragon.
Yeah. What does it really mean to live?
This topic sure got deep fast.
Yeah.
Jeez, I've been really good at avoiding, mystics. I'm pretty certain that Zavied had one, but, like, I haven't been mysticked in, like, 3 or 4 boss fights that have, like, Jude, Mila, Zavied, and Phoenix now. I wonder if there's just, like, a difference on how they pull them off. Ooh, jacketless outfit. Yeah.
Our scout ship has returned.
Done. I'd expect no less from Ifrit's crew.
Great. Let's do this one Rangetsu style, guys.
It worked.
Ooh, did we finally get there? Finally get it? Hibiscus corsage. Ooh.
Good luck out there.
Yeah, maybe I do just want to pull up the difficulty another tick. Wait, is that everything? I'm done? I'm actually done. That's it. That's every area, every attachment. There's still some materials I guess I'm missing, but those are pretty minimal compared to everything else. Like, they're just money at the end of the day. All right.
Show them how I...
I'm still moderate, right? Let's not put it on hard. We'll keep it on moderate for now. Ooh, what I did want to do... Let's check out that jacketless outfit and just see what it looks like. That's hair. Huh. That's nowhere near as bad as the other jacketless ones. Like, it still looks just fine. But I like it with the jacket better. Like, ain't the worst. It ain't the worst, but I like it better with the jacket, and I'm gonna keep it in the red. Also, we have a cat's chest. Without the jacket, he becomes a Wild West card player. That's a good way to put it. Alright, what do we got? That's a nothing, cats. That's fine. Nah, I'm good, thanks. It's only one battle. We'll just get one back and claw him. Yeah, getting the claw back was super easy. Never mind. Cool.
The path to victory is left, right,
straight.
Oh, I missed those sorts of things. What the heck? They only show up like 60 hours into the game? That's funky. Alright, let's head back to town. So we don't know where the dragon is now. But yeah, I will try to give enemies at least a little time enough to like try and pull out mystics, especially with ones that are like doubly so with Zavied. I kind of wanted him to pull out his mystic and see if it was the same one of the ones he has in Zestiria. I'm pretty damn certain it would be, you know? It's one of those sorts of things that, like, that's it. If you're gonna do the thing, you do it that way. So. Anyway, the first thing I want to do is check out the inn and stay there, because this will reset my, I was to say ATB, but my blast gauge. Also, speaking of which,
if I'm in this, I'm in this 100%.
Yeah, let's do that for now. I'll put Magilu back in, back in if I have to. Where to next, though? What did I say my next goal was gonna be on the map? I can go to Logris. That seems pretty good. Oh man, we could finish off Magilu's menagerie. That sounds fun. And then the Shrine of Tranquility. Wait, have I gone to Taliesin? Yeah, I have. That's where I got Zavied's quest in the first place. Yeah, I've been there. Okay. I don't know if Bottomless and Oath Bottle. I don't know if Bottomless and Oath Bottle exists. That'd be way too easy for movement if it did. Bonfires basically is what that would be. It would be the Lord Vessel if I had a bottomless one of those. Let's go to Logris. Logris sounds good. Keep picking up capsules on the way. We have enough for another chest and a half, basically. So I gotta keep picking them up. That's why I'm walking, actually. I'll be honest. It wouldn't surprise me if, like, Bottomless Enough existed, because it would be, like, again, it'd be the Lord Vessel. It'd be infinite movement and stuff, but we'll just go ahead and keep picking up cat souls, which are really what I'm after, basically all the time, you know? How many cat's chests are left? You know what? Let's see if we can find another cat's chest. I don't think there's a good way to search them, but every place has one, so Okay, cat chest there is good. Cat chest there is good. Where's the Morgana Woods cat chest? Oh, there it is. Okay. Cat chest. Oh, god damn it. Buttons there aren't exactly what I want them to be. Cat chest in town is good. Ooh, did I not find a cat's chest around here? Alright, Tranquil Woods, I have to give a double take just to see if there's a cat's chest there. Titania, I think I had the cat's chest here. See, I can see if the geo point's on. Like, it's on the right-hand side, you can see the geo point, but you can't see cat chest. Oh! There's something here. Yeah, I have the cat's chest here. Feigl Ice Caps, I should have the cat's chest at. It's like right here. It's the first cat's chest you get. Hellavies, we got that. Beardsley, we got that. Huddle Hotto, got that. We got that. Guyberk Icefield, we just got that. Mercio, we got that. Mount Killarouse, I think we had that one. Yep. Reneed. Reneed has another event in it, and we also got that. Fens of Nog, we got that. Warg Forest, we got that. It's right there. Burnick Plateau, we got that. It's right there. Lothgren, we got that. We got the one in the tunnel. Do we got the east tunnel? We got the east tunnel. Do we get Vortigern? Yeah, we got Vortigern. And we already know there's a quest thing here. Vortigern's was like... There. There's Vortigern's. Port Zexen, we got that one. Denon Highway, we got that one. Logris, we got that one. Barone Catacombs. Did we get this one? We did get that one. Logris Villa. We got that one. Lake Road. We got Lake Road. We got the Aldina Plains. We got Deval Forest. I'm pretty sure we got... Yeah, we got Deval Forest. Stonebury. Okay, we're good there. Small Grotto. I haven't been to this place. Den of Demons. I have just not been here. Alright, Zamal Grotto, I walked in and like got the map and left. So, oh, I might not have had like the board to cross. Alright, so Zamal Grotto, we gotta do that. Empyrean Throne, we got that one. Also, there's an event flag at the Empyrean Throne? Huh. Oh, importantly, this. If the Empyrean Throne is the exact same as Artorias' throne, that question mark in the center should be Hexen Island. That should be Hexen Island, because that was what it was in Zestiria when you went all the way up there. So this door to the sanctuary was where Heldulf was and you fought him. And that was the post-game dungeon, so Hexen. So, I guess we do have to go to the Empyrean Throne at some point to unlock more side quests? Which I guess I'll do at some point. But first... Did I hit the end? Oh, I didn't hit the end. Oh, well, Class 4 Administrative Zones, I'll have one. Let's quick go to the rest. So, yeah, I got sidetracked. So, Yvolg Ruins. We're good. Valley, we're good. Or Ravine, we're good. Fester Tunnels, we're good. And I'm pretty sure we're good in Cadnex. Yep, we're good in Cadnex. Hexen Island, yeah. Wait, we do have Hexen Island. Also, Hexen Island doesn't have a known, interesting. It has a Code Red demon, and I guess we haven't explored Hexen? So, we might not, like, I might not have actually had, seen the chest. So, we'll put Hexen on the list as well. Yep, we got that. I think we have Maclear Beach, Haria. Haria's got another new event in it. That's new. Minif Reef, we got Minif Reef. I'm pretty sure we got Palamedes Temple as well. Which also has an event? No, that's the Heavy Eater. Where did you leave off? I left off at Palamedes, so Lion of Life Island. Yep, that's good. I'm pretty sure Baird Marshes. Yep. So Cat's Corner doesn't have one. That makes sense. It's the Cat's Corner. We got this one. It's actually, no, we didn't. I have to go back to Terror Island. And then past Terror Island, we have some Class 4 administrative zones. Okay, that's got one. That does not have one. That does not have one. That does not have one. That has one. That does not have one. That does not have one. And then two other places that are probably Class 4 administrative zones. Alright, so we gotta go back to Terror Island at some point. Alright. Also, looks like we're gonna need a hell of a lot more cat souls if I wanna get all the cat soul stuff. So, alright. Good to know. I still don't really have a good way of farming these. I've got, like, okay ways, but nothing I would consider good. Because I probably need around, like, 3,000 to 4,000 more cat souls for all the chests that are left in the game. Would be my estimate. So every one of these matters. Luckily, like, this is actually pretty effective at picking them up. Like, I'm in an area where I can't get into random battles anymore because I just beat them in one hit on the broom. Do I expect the final dungeon to have cat chests? Artorias' throne probably does have a cat chest as well. Just based on, like, I expect there to be one more in that spot. Alright, let's head to the ship. We're leaving. Where are we leaving to? We'll figure it out. Alright. Let's get this out of the way. So I can't just drive back, or drive. I can't boat back to Hexen. It's just not a place. Return of this whole place. Oh my god, the Normans. Alright, back up here. Good ship. 525, spend them all. They'll run out of those eventually, I say, knowing fully well that there's 6 different Norman outfits that they can give to every single character in the game. Alright, let's go to... Isolt? Let's go to Isolt. We'll do Isolt, and then we'll do Reneed, probably. Yeah, Reneed's probably the next one. There's a thing to do in the sanctuary in town, which is over here. Yeah.
Haria village getting wiped out by demon blight. Really makes you think, doesn't it? Like if they had abandoned their faith in Amanoch and moved to Isolt, they might have been saved.
I'm glad they didn't come here. They deserved it. It's their punishment for heresy.
How could you? No one deserves that fate.
But didn't that priestess and her daughter turn first? That's what caused it to spread. But look at us here in Isolt. Not a single case of demon blight. That's the only possible explanation. They were crazy to resist the Abbey.
Shame on you. Don't speak ill of the dead. No one wants to become a demon. I had a friend in Haria. She was a good person. Whether she believed in Amanoch or Innominat, she was a person just like us. Our islands were her home.
Perhaps I have no right to say anything here, but please, don't ever lose that kind heart of yours. That's the best way you can honor the memory of Haria's people.
I won't. I'll go there soon with an offering of flowers.
but what of the other provinces? I heard the hero of Kvatch. Really makes you think. I can't take any, like, it's extremely hard for me to take somebody saying makes you think as anything but, like, sarcastic. When I'm saying it aloud, you have to know that the U is like the letter U when I'm saying it makes you think. Uh-huh. I guess I want to make that. I don't know how to audibly say the letter U versus the word U. At least not reliably, you know? Yeah, that's a good representation of it. Keep picking up these cat souls now that I'm freaking at nothing since I've spent them all on a Norman outfit. Idiot. Nah, you gotta do it. Hey, all the pengyons. Makes you think. The sage gnollingly bowed. Dumpus!
Not worth my time.
I won't improve by fighting weaklings.
Oh, equipment. Thank you for reminding me. Animalia ring becomes shell ring. Topaz waistcoat becomes mithril waistcoat. Dang, that's good. Death ward becomes amphibolite. And topaz boots. Oh, military hikes. All right, that's good. Feldspar garment, I think, becomes quartz garment. Yep. Valkyrie, which has an 8% no lose souls, becomes, okay. Topaz spear, quartz garment becomes topaz, and then we're good. The barbecue sauce one is one I will never forget. It's a very powerful tweet. Hey, Dumpus, get over here. You and other Dumpus are gonna join forces.
Here I come!
Hey, Dumpus. It was normal Dumpus. I love that you're immune to status effects while you're in the claw. That's maybe the most powerful part of it. I guess other than the not dying part, which is the actual most powerful part of it.
If you want to live, get out of my way.
I don't know how much I'm going to care about expeditions anymore. There's nothing left to do in them.
Show us your determination.
Like, what am I doing here anymore?
Good luck out.
Show them how I free.
Oh, right. This is actually the way down. Yeah, I guess I could target for food. Shrug. I missed one. You're not done until you have every Norman costume for every character. Yeah, ain't that the truth? Alright, so there is one thing to do here. Oh! The heck, there's people here? Alright.
I moved here from Isolt. I couldn't just abandon Aminocha's temple. But the Abbey and Innominat are important to me, too. It's not like I'm rebelling against them. I just think that these traditions and beliefs are part of our island's heritage. We have to honor them.
I think that's wonderful. But aren't you worried about the demons?
I asked the exorcists in Isolt for help. They said they couldn't station anyone here immediately, but they would send frequent patrols.
That's pretty tolerant, coming from the people who banned Aminoj worship in the first place.
Those who served under Lady Teresa have a strong sense of justice. They'll protect everyone, regardless of belief. No one has heard from Lady Teresa for some time now, but her people are trying to carry on her ideals.
All right. What'd you say? Yeah, better watch out for that Lord of Calamity. You know, sometimes she can be a real moron who wears winter clothing in on a tropical island. I don't know, just... Don't worry about it.
Let me...
I don't have the geo point here. Get off me, please. All right. What was noise? An excuse to give you fast travel? Sorta, basically. We're gonna back up from this spot. Noish did have a plot, a side plot in that game though, in Symphonia. There's a lot of cat souls here. This is actually where I did my first cat souls. Collection. I would just go through this place over and over again. I did it, five times in a row. And got myself, 900 or 800 cat souls. Which was pretty nice. There's a decent chunk of them here. And the enemies here aren't that bad. Basically, I outrun all of them, so I don't care. But there's a lot of cat souls here, which is really good. Oh, I did not curve that bullet right. Good old Geo Tree. There's not a ton of places left that I don't have the Geo Tree in, so.
Come on, really?
Yeah, early dungeons are definitely a point where there's going to be a lot of geo trees that I need to go find. And you can't see them on the map, so you gotta walk it. You have to check every room, because you don't know which one it could be. I think this room south here could have the geo tree. Really, I'm checking that room because that room actually has the most cat souls out of any room in this place. It's a very profitable place to be. Get off me, bird. I thought that was a double encounter, but it didn't give me the dangerous fallout, so...
No mercy.
Oh, I love it. Thanks, Luffy. I can't even warp there. Alright. We're walking the rest of this place. It's probably at the end. Whatever, I'm up to 200 and some cat souls now. Which is like either a small chest or a like half of a later chest. Like if I went back to the aberrant zone, the class 4 administrative zone. We probably have that. I do like that even if, like, these battles might not provide me with a lot of experience or anything useful in that much, they do provide a pretty hefty amount of, like, the grade they provide is still real. So, how many side quests do you have left anyway? No clue. I'm just going until it's cleared out. The big tell that I still have a long way to go is actually this. Missing tier 3. 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 In Zestiria, you got mystics by doing side quests near the end of the game. I'm making the assumption that the same thing is true in this game. So. Alright, don't want to warp here, want to huff the rest. As we might find the Geotree on the way. Nope, not on this one. Well, we knew it wasn't on this one, but how many screens does that leave? Let's actually warp it. It leads us to the last screen. That'll be actually better. It's more effective. Oh, it's right there. Alright, so I do have to make a little bit of a walk to get to it, but once I get it, we get to fly. I imagine, word number, that, like, if I do all these, like, side quests and stuff, I'll be a little bit overleveled for the end of the game, like, the final bosses and such, but that isn't going to stop me from doing all this. And we're off. Two sixty, that's a good number. But yeah, so I imagine the side quest stream stuff will continue for quite some time. I think I've been keeping a pretty good pace, though. Like, at this point, I think I've done 3 streams a week of this, like, for something like 2 months? Month and a half? How long has this game been out? Like, month and a half to 2 months. It's been some time, I suppose. It's not like I'm powering through it. And it's also like this isn't the only game I'm playing is the bigger thing. It's true. Vesperia did have... Okay, so Vesperia had a third form on Duke if you collected all the fell arms. You know, that's weird. Okay, let me talk about fell arms. That's a Tales tradition that just fell off the planet. What the hell? So, do we have major side quests left? Yeah, we definitely do. We still have Zavied hanging out somewhere. We still have, like, a lot of, like, these probably lead into major ones is the thing. Like, I have no idea what the distinction between major and minor is on all these. Both of these two I see as major, but these two, the Rokuro's Blade and the Heavy Eater, could lead into stronger ones. So, the fell arms, let me talk about those, because there's something that just, again, sort of like disappeared from the series as of late. The fell arms were like weapons that scaled the number of kills you got. Like, specifically, they scaled with, with how many kills you had. So, they were extremely powerful by the end of the game. And a lot of Tales games had a side quest that was associated with them. Symphonia had a Fell Arms quest that you were collecting them for Abyssian, I think it was? I think it was Abyssian was the boss you ended up fighting. No, Vesperia had them, Squirrel Token. By the way, I found the tree. In Vesperia, the Fell Arms were, again, they existed. They were these, like, weapons that each character got one, and they scaled with your number of kills you got. But if you got all of the Fell Arms in the game, Duke, the final boss, had, actually, like, got more difficult, or had a third form, sorry, didn't get more difficult, he had a, like, this angel form thing that, like, gotcha. Yeah. Alright, well, looks like we're fighting a giant slime? I don't know. This is weird.
We can do this!
It's the demon-eating demon!
The more it eats, the more ferocious it gets, right?
I'd rather not find out. Let's take it down, fast!
Don't let him eat the slimes! 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 Just don't let him eat the slimes! You can't eat the slimes. You can't have them. No, no, no slimes! What are you weak to? What were the not spirits called in Vesperia? I think they were just called spirits. Unless you're talking about Entelechea.
I unleashed all my power. Maybe I overdid it.
Entelechea were the entities before spirits. Oh! Halves damage. Oh! Holy crap! You put them in the hole. So if you get put in the hole, you aren't going to get murdered. That is super nice.
Ooh, I don't know how, but we managed to beat it.
It devoured other demons purely by instinct. Sounds kind of like me, doesn't it?
So you've eaten a few cows, or demons, whatever. When you're hungry, you eat. The only ones who put any moral weight on it are humans. Personally, I wouldn't sweat it too much. What are you trying to say?
It's fine. I don't really care if I'm seen as a bad guy.
I don't really know how to put it, but I sensed a kind of strength inside that demon. Like a determination to continue living. It was powerful and frightening, but I don't think it was bad.
Figures.
Oh, yep. Velvet did indeed eat. We ate a demon. Anything else in this area? Doesn't look like it. Alright, we're good. But yeah, so the Fell Arms just sort of disappeared from the series from, like, after that point. Like, you know? It's just like, yep, we sort of dropped off on these weapons. Specifically, like, Zestiria doesn't have anything like it. They might have been in Zillia, I guess, but, like, the fact that they're not in both of these is interesting, I suppose. Zillia did have fell arms. Okay, that's good. Then it must just be a recent thing that, like, they dropped off the face of the earth. Kinda sad. Also, like, so let's talk about other things that are, like, a very constant staple in Tales games. Sword Dancer boss fight as a bonus boss. You always gotta fight the Sword Dancer. Like, the Sword Dancer was this, like, sort of optional boss that appeared in a number of Tales games that was like a... Again, both Vesperia and Symphonia had them. In Symphonia, it was like a recurring boss. You could fight him, I think, 3 times. And I'm pretty sure it was in Abyss as well. And, yeah... So again, like, I know I can fly places, but I want cat souls. Specifically, I am walking most places for the cat souls rather than flying. What was the other game I can think of that had, like, leveled... like, bosses to what you did. Ridley, the final boss in, Zero Mission actually scales if you have 100% items. Specifically, if you have 100% items has a scaling feature. Oh. Yeah, I huff it on the... I walk sometimes... Mostly because it's, like, half because I forget and half because it gets hard to pick up these cat souls while on the board because I can't do precision movement. So I just get off the board. But yeah, definitely, like, the Mecha Ridley had scaling to you if you had 100% item completion when you went and fought him. What else? FF8, the entire game, scales to you. With two exceptions. Two? I think it's two exceptions. Pretty sure that Ultima and Omega Weapon don't. I think it's both Ultima and Omega. I know Ultima Sia even scales to you. Which is hilarious. Like, you get to Ultima Sia and she's level 8. Actually, now that I think about it, maybe, like, one of the later halves of Ultimate Sia's fight doesn't scale. Can I do a kickflip? Nah. No kickflips here. We are not radical enough for that. But yeah, the FF8's scaling is, like, one of its biggest features and also one of its most breakable features. Because, like, your level doesn't actually... Your stats don't heavily depend on your level. They depend on your junctioned magic and all that jazz. FF8 is a very odd place. Alright, nothing left in this town. We haven't found the Hawk Demon that teaches sweet tricks and combos. Is that board repeat actually on the board? Repeat board. FF8 is the worst intersection of FF2 and FF7? Yeah, but FF2 is worse, though. Is the secret. I don't even know if that's a secret. FF2 kind of sucks. I don't like it. Alright, I think next I said we were going to need, because we have two things to do here. I want to touch on, I am not an FF2 liker. I have tried to play that game something like 3 times. And every time I've just been unhappy playing it. Whereas FF8, I love because it has all these systems and then you just ignore them and it rules. You're like, yeah, I could, like, do all these, like, draw magic and whatever, but what if I played cards for 30 minutes? How's that sound? And then you're like, oh, cards for 30 minutes? Is that enough? And then, yeah, that's good. You don't really need to play more cards than that. Then you turn all your cards into powerful magic, and then you're invincible. And you waltz through the game as this invincible party. It kind of rules. Like that a lot.
Scout.
Oh, are you enjoying FF13 so far? Yeah, for the most part, though. I'm of two minds in the game. I've had a bit of time to codify my thoughts on it, and like, really, the way I put it is that FF13 is a game of like extremes. It does things extremely well or extremely poorly, and a lot of the bigger things fit into category 2. Everything is very hit or miss. Anyway, we're going to talk to this person now, so I'm not going to talk about 13 for another minute or two. I'll talk about it after this.
The boss has a request for you.
Not a message, but a request.
A Whitehorn dragon has been showing up in the Aldina Plains. The boss wants you to kill it.
Since when did the Bloodwings become agents of justice? Interested in protecting the world from dragons?
Hey, we're not out to save the world. This is just to put an end to Zavied's madness.
Did Zavied do something in particular?
He's been harassing exorcists, trying to get more information on that dragon. That's got the Abbey on alert, which makes trouble for us. Our spies in the Abbey can't operate under these conditions.
And that's where we come in. Does that mean Zavied is in the Aldina Plains too?
Got it in one. Just be careful. Zavied and that dragon are even more agitated than usual.
Let's go.
Are you gonna fight Zavied again?
The time has come.
Oh, I might have a second bite at Zavied showing off a mystic. Alright, if we have to fight Zavied a second time, I am going to let him show off the mystic, no matter what. But yeah, so, okay, to expand on... Yo, dude. Okay, to expand on what I mean about FF13... FF13 is extremely, like... Like, when I'm... Like, when I was fighting the Havoc Sky Tank in the last one, I was having a ton of damn fun. Like, that battle was, like, pretty hectic. I had to swap between, like, party structures multiple times, which is the mechanic I have a lot of fun with. Like that, and it was this really cool set piece. Like, you're literally, like, three people... It kind of showed off how powerful Lassie actually are. But then the game insists on spending 15 hours, like, with you playing... Oh, an herb. With you playing with, like, two party members just so that you learn how to use Saboteur, or just so that you learn to respect Sentinel... Which is something that could have been done in, like, 15 minutes. Instead of, like, 6 hours. Pacing is an issue with that game. Is, I guess, what I'm saying. What else? Again, and on the topic of very hit or miss, its cast feels very hit or miss. The thing I loved about FF2 is that I was allowed to ignore the whole plot and punch myself while bees ran away from me while only having one living party member carry the game, walk over to the second to last city for great armor. Okay, that placing it that way is very silly, and that is what the game is. It's just also... Like... The fact that you have to do that is the part I dislike. Emperor's pretty good. Yeah, Emperor's pretty good. As far as FF2, I can give the FF2, I can't take away the Emperor from FF2. That's one of its, like, best features, is the Emperor. Yo, you killed me, so I took over hell. And now I'm back. Like, that's pretty damn sweet. Had some extreme development problems, yeah. It's, again, everything's very hit or miss. The other point I want to bring up about FF13 was something that I realized in the last stream and has been bugging me constantly ever since. And that's a problem of geography or topography or, like, positioning. So, as an example, I'll talk about the world I'm in right now where I know how to get from one place to the other. Like, I know how to get from, like, even though I'm taking a ship between some locations, I can be on this board and I know, okay, I just need to go south for a little while and I end up in the village of Renied and the port of Renied, and then from Renied, I know what the Renied looks like. I know what Logris looks like. I know how to get around Logris. There's, like, it's a huge city. It's a cool place to be. Every single area, every single piece of geography, every single city we've been in, every single place we've been in FF13 has none of that. And it came to a head with Palimporum, which is this city you enter, and I can't tell you anything about what the city looks like, I can't tell you about the geography of the city, I can't tell you what, like, districts exist in the city, I can't tell you how to get from the north side to the south side. I can't tell you if there's a north side. I can't tell you anything about Palimporum. You get teleported between a bunch of different areas, and then you're there. And that's actually just kind of how the game goes when you're going around Cocoon. It's like, and then you're teleported from here to here. Obviously, teleported might be incorrect. Sometimes you, like, fly. Sometimes you switch parties. But you just end up in places, and there's nothing, like, there's no, I couldn't show you or tell you a map of what Cocoon looks like, and that bothers me a ton. One of the biggest things that I like in a game, and it's taken me a long time to realize that this is something I enjoy and or like about a game, is, like, or at least codify. I guess I've known it's something I've liked for a long time. FF13 is basically the awkward transition between Makalania Temple, stuff happens out here in the desert, but, like, even that, like, I can tell you where all those locations are, and, like, yeah, you get, like, thrown in the desert basically at random there, but, like, you have a goal, and you have a physical goal, and you're going to all these temples, and you know you're going to all these temples. You're not living in the world, you're just channel surfing. Yeah. So, but one thing, and Tails does this better than most games I've played. This is a bit unrelated to my point about geography. Is that one of the biggest things I like about a character or a, like, multiple characters or a faction is knowing how they're going to act, knowing their motivations, and realizing that their actions match their motivations. And even if their actions are stupid, if they match what their motivations are and they're consistent with who that character is as a person, it's 100%, like, I accept it, okay? Like, that's cool. Like, yeah, excellent. Where am I going in here, by the way? Oh, I'm going upstairs. That is, how do I even get there? Oh, I passed it. Shit. So, having characters who are doing... No, I need to go to the south here. Okay. Having characters who, like, their their motivations make sense. Their actions make sense with who they are. Or, like... Not even just that. No, that's the way I... God damn it. I'm getting turned around. I need to go left from here. Okay. So, and this is, again, something that 13 does not do well most of the time. And by most of the time, I mean, let's say half. Well, maybe half's not being true enough. Basically, like, with FF13, the characters I like the most are the ones I understand. The ones I can see why they're taking an action, and even if I maybe don't agree with what they're doing, but it makes sense. Like, I actually really like Hope so far because, like, I understand what Hope is doing. This isn't where I want to go. God, I need to be on the other side. Hell. I went to the wrong roof. Okay. But it doesn't bother me, like, that at all. Or, like, right now, like, I've only been vaguely introduced to Fang, but she makes sense with what she's doing, even though I, like, because she's laid out her motivation pretty clearly. And I might not know who she is or what drives her, but at least I buy that that is something that she wants to do. So... But, like, I still don't know what the hell Lightning's actual, like, character and motivation is, and I... Like, it also is probably the reason that people like Saz more than the rest of the cast, but at least one of them. Squirrel Token, I don't want that information, dude. You keep telling me things like that, and it's like... Please stop. Please. There was a point in the stream earlier where I made a joke about, like... Fang being asleep for a week or like a couple years, and you corrected me on a piece of information there's no way I could know. Like, the fact that Fang had been asleep for hundreds and hundreds of years, and it's like, that, dude, please. That's just spoiling stuff. That's not called anything.
I see you've come, Shigure.
Count Capilus. It's been a long time.
Oh, wait. Is that you, Rokuro? Leave now. You are not the one who I summoned here. I want your brother, the traitor Shigure.
Sir, if I'm not mistaken, I believe Shigure's execution was assigned to me.
Ha! Oh, please. Don't make me laugh. You had your chance. You couldn't even scratch him, you wretched dog. Frankly, I don't need any Rangetsu to do my bidding any longer. Not with the power that I've attained by devouring everyone in the entire manor. I shall administer your punishments myself, with my own hand.
You're the one who devoured the people at the manor? How could you do that?
I never knew humans were so delicious. After I make a meal of you and the rest of those damnable exorcists, this will be my kingdom, my feeding ground.
Welp, it looks like the only thing that got abducted was this guy's conscience.
Remain there, Rokuro. Your lord commands you. Wait and be thankful that your blood will stain my blade beside your brother's.
There's no reasoning with this guy.
Wait.
Rokuro?
I refuse. If you simply wanted to eat flesh, then perhaps I wouldn't stop you. But dying to you would make a mockery of the Rangetsu name. Turn your blade on me or my brother and we won't hold back. Not even against an impotent lord.
You! How dare you speak to your master like that?
Rock!
Yeah, this was very clearly meant to be done before the mountain.
This cur has fangs he's all too happy to use. No escape!
Alternate color outfit for Mogulu. Damn it, I tried to use my... There we go. I love doing these chains, by the way.
There's no stopping them now!
Good catch!
No escape!
Fertile blue! Four four!
Hurricane!
Earthquake!
Rising thunder! How could this happen?
Oh, I'm gonna die! I'm gonna die! No. Yep, I'm dead. I knew that was coming. I got stunned and paid for it. Let's go pick up that over there. This guy has too much health? Nah. My mystics just weren't far in a combo. Like, if I was further in a combo, I would have done more damage. There we go.
Come on, put up some fight, okay?
Well, that went well. Well enough with the death. Victory under status ailment. Oh, that sucks. That's a lot to lose. Okay, 35. How many BG can you actually have?
I'm sorry. I know you were hoping to negotiate an alliance.
Don't worry. I don't think he's someone we could fight alongside.
Come on, Rokuro. You wanted to kill him from the very start, didn't you?
No. Well, maybe a little.
So you did want to.
You're a pretty scary guy when push comes to shove. Whatever happened to honoring your ancestral debt?
I don't think I'm a hypocrite. My debt was made when I was human. That has nothing to do with the demon I am now.
That's how you really look at it?
I do. I incurred my debt toward you after I became a demon, and you can count on me to repay it.
I'll take your word for it, then.
But Rokuro, when the Count said he was going to kill Lord Shigure, was that really something impossible to forgive?
How do I say it? I will kill anyone who disparages Arangetsu's skill. That's all. That's just nonsense. I'm sure I sound like the Count. I won't ask you to understand.
Of course I don't understand. But still, I don't think it's nonsense. There are just some things a person can't surrender.
Nope, alright.
Not worth my time.
Yeah, the old me is dead thing is a very common throughout our party. Eleanor hasn't directly had it, but she's a very different person.
You're not hurt, are you?
Now no, than she was at
I'm
the
fine.
Start. But she hasn't given up her... Like, she hasn't flat... Like, I don't know. I'm sure she'll have a moment with Artorias of, like, tearing down her. Alright, what's next? I don't think there's anything left here. Truth of the past? Let's do Truth of the Past, and then we'll do everything on this continent. So we want to go to Taliesin. Okay, nothing in Taliesin, that's fine. Alright, I'm walking it again for the same reasons I brought up before. I want the cat souls. We're up to 500 again, nice. It's been a profitable experience to just walk. Well, I say walk as we're floating around on this hoverboard, but you know, you get what I mean. Walking, relatively. Anyway, I'm done yakking about FF13. Suffice to say, what I said about it's like the whole disconnect of, honestly, Pelimporum was a real like point of disconnect for me. But I really, again, I liked the Havoc Sky Tank fight. That was hella cool. So yeah, we should get, I think this is going to be, did I talk to all the Maliks here? Yes, I did. And they had a lot of important things to say, like name-dropping Zenris, which I thought was pretty hella cool. Hard to say who my flat favorite is, but I think right now the half of the cast I like the most is Fang, Saz, and Hope. What is your favorite Kirby game? Be warned, there is a correct answer. Oh, that's a good one. What is my favorite Kirby game? I'm gonna say Superstar because it's the one I've played the most by far, and I played like one of the things that really was important to me about games way back in the day was multiplayer. The multiplayer aspect of Superstar was huge, so that me and my brother could both play it. And we did a lot. So, and then, like, that's not counting, like, on that same aspect, I think Return to Dreamland was also a really big one, but that was, again, because, like, a bunch of us could play it together. What's your favorite Kirby power? Does sleep count? I don't think sleep counts, but if sleep counts, I'll say sleep. How long did I have the little naughty... like... I think my actual favorite power is either, like, is, like, one of the superstar powers I use the most. Hey, hold on. Let's grab this one here. I liked Yo-Yo. I liked Mir, but not as much as Yo-Yo. I liked Plasma a lot, but I think Plasma got better in later Kirby games. Alright. Well, into the Earth Pulse.
That definitely looks like an Earth Pulse entrance.
I don't sense Enominat here.
We still need to be careful. We might have ousted him from the Earth Pulses, but the four Empyreans are in play now.
If we want to learn anything useful, we'll need to go inside. Be ready for anything.
All right. Time for flashback zone. God, it's again, kind of stunning how much more willing I am to buy the conceit of the Earth Pulse in this game, because the game has taken the goddamn time to, like, explain it.
If you want to live, get out of my way.
Okay. Did you ever go into... No, you never went into the Earth Pulse in Zestiria. In Zestiria, the Earth Pulse was this, like... it was just, like, brought up once and just like, oh yeah, by the way, whatever. Just, like... It was brought up just so the game could do flashbacks and, like, never really explain and just, like, offhanded, like, oh yeah, by the way, this is the power of Mautellus or something. I don't know. Believe me. So, yeah. Oh, if I've been gone the whole time, that's, yeah. Oh, risky encounter. But yeah, Redigito, I'm happy to help, like, with, making thoughts on RPGs, like, make sense. Because, like, again, like, it's, you want to talk things through.
We one, right?
I don't know, I like talking right? out my thoughts a lot. It's something, it's honestly the reason I like doing, like, streaming card stuff is because I don't feel like such a butt when I'm, like, talking out my thought process. Yeah, no music at all here. It was a bit funky. Oh, favorable encounter. What about back attack? Oh, sure. Also, I really need to switch Mogulu back into the front. Oh, now that I've said that out loud again, like, I guess one of the things we're gonna have to resolve in Artorias' throne is, like, is the whole Mautelus thing?
Forget about it.
Hmm. That'll be interesting. Because I showed that little skit from Zestiria. Yeah, there's like nothing here. It's very... Right.
Why, certainly.
Heading out.
Swap you in.
Oh, can't a witch get a little downtime? Understood. Let's do...
Me?
Be sure...
Eleanor in the lead. A gun can prove useful here.
And with that, the oath is now formed. Ceres, take heed. I've now embedded a portion of the art formula within your corporeal form. Over the next several months, it should take hold and crystallize using the power of the oath.
The art you'll use to control the power my body has accumulated?
That is correct. Brunhild, the sorcerer's ring. It is an art that was lost long, long ago on this continent. Reviving it requires considerable investment.
So that is why you tied the oath to my life force. The formula will only be completed once I've died.
Do you have something to say?
No. I understand that this is a necessary step in order to realize armatization and bring Innominat under your control. And even though Siegfried possesses a similar power, Lord Melchior has yet to successfully locate the device. Knowing that, our research must be accelerated. That is the only reasonable way.
Then you understand. From here on, you are to focus on completing the Sorcerer's Ring.
As you say.
I trust you're not having any second thoughts about this? She's a Moloch. Here to serve and nothing more. And today, she's proved herself quite loyal.
Yes. I am Ceres. I am your Moloch. I am simply a tool for you to fulfill your ideals. So Ceres took her oath to make armatization possible.
But what a heavy price to make her pay.
And Artorias did it knowing that she was his reincarnated wife.
Oh, who am I to talk? There was a time not long ago when I'd have done the same thing.
Regardless, things are now starting to come together. What happened to Ceres and to Eifried and Siegfried? It's all related. This all occurred so Artorias could armatize with Innominat and control him.
And then Zavied ended up devouring that power and making herself public enemy number one. How deliciously ironic.
No, Ceres knew what was going on, and she still...
But the Abbey has secured Siegfried's formula, and they're almost certainly using it to complete Innominat's Armatus.
Let's keep going, Zavied.
Yeah, we've come too far to turn back now. I'll see this through to the end.
Oh, so that's what that's the Brunhild that they were talking about. There's a person... I'll go talk to them after this. There's a person talking about Brunhild and Siegfried. Who's his unborn son? Hi. Yeah. So, I guess we have a... Like, does that mean the the ability for us to eat Therians is a or to eat demons and stuff is like similar to armatization, or like I guess similar in some way. Oh, by the way, the Sorcerer's Ring, it's been a long time since we've talked about it, but it is it's a very common thing in almost every Tales game. Like, the Sorcerer's Ring is... let's us do the claw. Yeah, it's like, well, maybe not the claw, but like, yeah, oh, okay, it just lets us do Break Soul. Yeah, that's powerful enough. Like, I guess, does it have a plot use other than the... Shrug. Anyway, the point I was trying to make before people pointed out that I was dead wrong about what the hell I was talking about, Sorcerer's Ring is just a thing that's in all sorts of Tales games. There was a Sorcerer's Ring, like Eternia, there is usually a key item that shoots a little, like, pew, in front of you. And, like, that's just what it does, and opens locks, and it opens doors, and sometimes it has different elements, and sometimes there's a fire and ice one, and sometimes it's just, like, it fires a little pew-pew blast that opens things. But, yeah, that's just how... It's been in a lot of Tales games. Please don't catch me. That's terrible. Because I don't have Spell Absorber now. Oh, well. Bam! Yeah. So the Break Soul thing that I'm doing here is what the Sorcerer's Ring lets me do. These powers.
Try as they might, it won't change.
I keep getting risky encounters against those enemies because I'm just not fast enough to avoid them.
It's been a full century since Midgand reunited the fractured land. In that time, we've enjoyed a blissful era of peace and prosperity. But the world has also seen its faith and moral purity slowly decay, only to be supplanted by deep, profound sin. Things have gotten so bad that nobody has even realized that the four Empyreans now slumber. I'm entirely certain that demons will only become ever more rampant, and yet I'm powerless to stop it.
Empyreans? Demons? What are you talking about?
I'm sorry. You shouldn't have to hear me grumble. You've already done so much for me.
It's fine, really. You've seen so much of the world. Things that I never even knew existed.
Yes. I've seen mountains spew flame, and lands covered in ice. I've crossed stormy seas, and ravines deeper than the eye can see.
That's so amazing. Weren't you ever frightened?
Of course. We are nothing in the face of nature. It takes so little for a person to lose their life out in the wilds. But in spite of the terror, those seas, the mountains, the forests, the deserts, they're absolutely breathtaking. And even in the harshest of climes, people still find a way to live there and carve out something resembling a home.
I think I understand you now.
How do you mean?
I can tell you really love this world. Not just that, but all the people who live in it, too.
The world and its people. Do you really think so?
I'm sure of it. Just remember that you're one of those people, too, you know? You really should try to take care of yourself a little more.
can't do anything right. How could I possibly learn to like myself?
I believe in you, Arthur. I mean, my family and I are already quite fond of you just the way you are, no matter your faults.
Thank you, Celica.
That was Velvet's sister and Artorias.
That's how I remember Celica. And him, too.
I see.
Lord Artorias.
Eleanor, I know that the Exorcists believe from the bottom of their hearts that their work will save everyone.
Perhaps. But that won't stop you from fighting them, will it?
No, it won't.
Oh, isn't ignorance bliss? Should we really keep digging up the past like this?
Velvet's never been one to pick the easy road.
What's wrong, kiddo? I was just thinking. The Earth in Historia is supposed to be a vast record of world history. It could show us anything. So why does it only ever focus on events related to Velvet's life?
Perhaps it's reacting to her presence. Or maybe, since this place used to be a Nominat's vessel, his power is still influencing what we're seeing.
If that were true, shouldn't you be able to control the Earth in Historia, kiddo? You're supposed to be part of Enominat. Think of all the juicy secrets we could dig out of the past! Oh, I'm getting pins and needles!
I'm not so sure. Having that much access might be frightening. Some things aren't so fun to learn about.
I was just gonna ask that question. Like, why are these so specifically laser-targeted flashbacks, but... Alright, game. Somebody asked if this was related to Zestiria. Yeah, it is. One of your party members is directly related to a party member from Zestiria. Don't hold that against this game. I keep hearing those spirits. Oop. There's another one of those spirits. Oop, okay. Alright, we're almost to the end here, which is the truth of the past. Yeah, yes I have, Squirrel Token. The Dawn Dusk one. It's again. I'm of two minds on the card. It's a very interesting design, but also like I think like part of it is like the art is the biggest thing that's gonna suffer on the card. Oh, that's no good, Counting Kittens. Hopefully, it's something easy to fix. Replacing RAM or something, I don't know. Nope, come on, get over here. Fireball!
You won't get any pity or compassion from me.
God, I need to, you know one thing I need to do that I don't look forward to? I need to spend 20 minutes at a equipment shop and disenchant everything in my inventory. That's gonna suck. I don't look forward to that activity.
I hear that you've finally gotten your assignment. Have they given you a name yet?
Moloch number 2.
That isn't your name.
Huh?
You don't remember anything, do you? But of course you don't. You died before you were even born.
I...
But my memories, They came back. And these memories, they torment me. I can never replace them. And I can't undo them.
I don't really understand.
You don't have to. Just know that I was happier before my memories and free will reawakened. If I had one wish, I'd wish that you stay the way you are.
You're going?
I'm about to free someone who can kill the strongest Empyrean and the Head Exorcist. I suppose you could call it revenge. Against myself and against my past. Goodbye. Please, find it in your heart to forgive your mother when she failed to protect you.
Wait, what? How'd we get here? This is the prison island!
Probably by an Earth Pulse warp. I'll have to send for the Von Eltia to come get us.
I guess I must have met Ceres at some point, but I don't have any memory of it happening.
But why would that place connect to here?
Well, I mean, this is an Earth Pulse point, isn't it?
Ceres might have willed it to be somehow.
What do you mean?
Velvet is right. I think the Earth in Historia showed us that memory because Ceres wanted us to see it. Or Velvet and Laffy said, at least.
I think I understand. And I think I agree.
It may have taken us all the way out here, but at least we have something to show for it. I suppose we can't complain.
Yeah.
This was worthwhile.
All right. Let's get to the harbor.
I can think and decide for myself now, but it's kind of nice. I feel alive like this. So rest easy, Mom. I'll be okay.
Oh, hey, a color variant outfit. Well, that was nice. Yo, that freaking rule. Oh my god, wait. Is this my Sonic the Hedgehog outfit? Like, this is like my Sonic the Hedgehog outfit. Yeah. I'd have to change my hair spike. I'm going back to pirate clothing. I like my pirate clothes. I haven't been on them for a little while. I think the hair needs a change too. And you may ask yourself, you may find yourself living in a shotgun shack. How did I get here? No, seriously, how did... Well, if I'm singing that, I need to wear a suit that's too big. I don't have a suit that's too big, though. So how do we get the boat here? Do we just have to call the boat? I have to send a Sylph Jay to be like, hey, yeah, you know how we were in point in like Taliesin? Get over here. Which, okay, I find it funny that I question that more than I question using the bottomless bottles, but you know. Also, I think we have a skit here somewhere. Yeah, over there by the south side. We'll do this. We'll go there. water flowing under as days go by. Once in a lifetime. I like that song a lot. It's a good one. Okay, yeah, here it was. No, sorry, not here. It was the next room over. Whoopsie! Down here and then over to the side room. Yeah. Yeah, Renegito, very agreed. And yes, Ishimaru Hayato, this game does show you where all these optional skits are just on the map, and they're not all just in an inn, which is, much better. It's all, the skits in Zestiria are all at the one inn, and they're not in this game.
Times do I have to tell you? You just don't get it.
You're the one who doesn't get it. You're just making a lot of trouble where there shouldn't be any, old man.
What did you just call me? Say that again. I dare you.
Both of you, shut up already. You're making so much noise that I'm tempted to devour your heads just to get some peace and quiet.
Honestly, I find it odd how you pirates, who are on the same side, are always fighting. Yet you don't hesitate to rescue shipwrecked Abbey sailors who are your enemy.
What's so hard to understand about that?
You're treating your ally like your enemy, and your enemy like your ally.
Seriously? You still have a lot to learn, apparently.
What the hell does the Abbey teach you, exorcists? You talk all about going around helping people, but you don't know the first thing about sailing.
Are you implying that the first thing about sailing is to help your enemies?
I can't explain it to the likes of you. Benwick, you explain it to our esteemed exorcist here.
Well, you see, when somebody out at sea is in trouble, we don't refer to them as allies or enemies. You might think nothing of being aboard a ship, but take a moment to think about how vast and deep the ocean is. Now imagine if you weren't on a ship, if you were out here alone. Sends chills down your spine, doesn't it?
I guess I can't argue with you there.
Out on the sea, even just a single board of driftwood can mean the difference between staying afloat and succumbing to the depths of the water. That's why even when we raid and sink a ship, we pull up anybody who took for the water, and we bring them aboard.
I know it sounds hypocritical to attack someone's ship and then rescue them out of the water, but that's just the way things are on the sea.
You pirates are an interesting bunch.
Plus, if the people we rescue end up getting another ship, we can attack them again, and take all their new loot.
You don't go and kill every last prickle boar in the forest, or else you won't have any more to hunt later. It's the way of the world.
And my faith is gone.
All right, but why were you two fighting to begin with?
Oh right, that! I remember why! Benwick here came up and started squeezing lemon juice on the perfectly fine fried chicken I just made!
Who wouldn't do that? It's normal.
The way you drench it takes away all the seasoning and complexity of flavor that I worked so hard to get right!
No way! You have to at least put that much on, or it's not worth eating at all.
Oh, forget about the chicken. Who wants to douse these two in a bucket of water instead?
Make it ice water.
Oh, I'm so glad that Dial and Benwick get some skit time there. That's good.
Scout.
That's good stuff. All right, we got a couple more of these, it looks like. Well, these are like the pirate skits. I love them. I love the pirate. Our secondary crew, our B team, is so good.
Dial, Medissa wants to use some octopus demon to make dinner tonight. Let's go catch some together.
Okay, sure. We can go as soon as I'm all done here.
Okay, but hurry!
You and Kamalana seem to have become really good friends.
Yeah, I guess she's really latched on to me.
I think it meant a lot that you protected her when we were attacked at Titania. She told me that lizards usually feel cold to touch, but that you have a warm heart deep down.
That's not me at all! I'd have run away if I had my tail back, but I'd already gotten surprised and dropped it, so what else could I do but fight?
Oh yeah, I guess you'd lost your tail, hadn't you?
Has Kamalana stopped trying to scare you after that?
It looks like it, yeah. Long enough for my tail to regrow again, at least.
Oh, it's back! I didn't see.
Boo!
Oh no, his tail!
Kamalana, sweetie. You know better than to scare Dial.
But he's being so slow! He kept me waiting too long. But... I'm sorry.
It's all right. It'll grow back again. And besides, lizard tails make the best bait for octopus demons. I'm sorry I kept you waiting. Now how about we go catch us some dinner?
Yay! Let's go, Dial. Let's go!
Oh, that was our whole B team. I love it. Harvesting slowpoke tails. Yep. It's definitely harvesting slowpoke tails. Alright. We're gonna head to Logris. Let's just warp to the other side. So, in Logris, we're gonna have the end of the Mogulu thing, and then we're also going to, it's gonna be sweet. We're gonna have the end of the Zavied thing as well, it feels like. So, we'll do Mogulu's first, Zavied's second, and see where everything else leads. That's a good island. I want Zexen, Port Zexen. So from here, we want to go to Logris, which is over this way. And we're gonna do the Mogulu thing, I can't wait. Dial losing his tail reminds me of that joke from Xenoblade Chronicles X, where Well, see, the difference is that joke is super forced. You are literally forced to hear that joke every single time you start a story mission, and it's the same joke. Xenoblade Chronicles X, the game where, like, all of the side content is, like, head and shoulders above the main content. It's kind of funny. Ooh, here we go. Alright. Mogulu's troop versus Mogulu. Let's do it. This is gonna be good.
Shall we?
Showtime, Mogulu! Come out and face me, preferably unprepared.
Mogulu isn't doing any shows right now.
Hmm? Why not? Oh, did she get scared when she heard that the Enfu and I were teaming up?
No. Mogulu and her teacher had a big fight. From what I've heard, it sounds like she's run away from home.
Do you know what happened?
She just kept going on about how she wanted a break from practicing.
So? She's young. She probably just wants to go out and have some fun.
Preposterous! If she takes even one day off, it takes three to get her back in form!
Even so, shouldn't you at least hear her out?
All I've done is hear her out. She mentioned something about wanting to go to the Zamal Grotto, but I wouldn't have any...
Did you say Zamal Grotto? That place is a nest of vicious demons!
What?
Vicious demons, you say?
If Modulu really went there, then victory could end up being mine by default.
This isn't a joking matter. We have to go look for Modulu.
Oh, my precious Lulu.
Yeah, I think what Zane Zero is saying is pretty right. That, Xenoblade X focuses on the world to the detriment of the rest of the thing. Though, funnily enough, I like the gameplay in Xenoblade better. Like, even the gameplay has, like, a number of issues. Though you get a giant mech, so, hell. Oh, hold on, we got a couple. The inn and the tavern both have a stopping point, so let's do both of those. Excellent. I like that I can scout for these. Oh, right.
I heard you guys managed to beat Shigure Rangetsu.
Word travels fast again, as usual.
As I understand it, succession of the Rangetsu clan goes to the one who kills his predecessor. That means you're the successor, Rokuro. Or have you taken the name Shigure now?
You have to kill the head of the clan to succeed them?
I don't intend to step up as the new head. But how do you know about my family's customs?
We're all part of the same underworld. Word travels. A long time ago, we tried to assassinate another Shigure. But we lost 30 of our number instead.
Naturally. It'd take more than that to do a Shigure in.
In retrospect, I wonder if even 300 men would have been enough. Your Shigures are a tough bunch. Look at your brother. He was a legate.
Yeah, he was probably the strongest head the clan ever had.
That being said, did you know there's a demon out there not even he managed to cut down?
Are you serious?
That must be some crazy demon if a legate couldn't even take it down.
Tell me about it.
It was a swordsman who looked like a dragon. Shigure was sent to exterminate it, but came away empty-handed. And quite recently, it was sighted at the Empyrean's throne.
Sounds like a job only I can handle.
Wait! You're not the only one here. Only fools rush in.
Don't bother, Mogilu.
Yeah, you should know better. He won't listen.
Besides, I think we're all fools here.
Point taken.
A dragon swordsman not even Shigure could kill. I'm getting excited just thinking about it.
Good luck.
We're all fools here. I love it. Alright. Empyrean's Throne is still going to be a while till we go there, but now we have like three reasons to check it out, so that's good. Let's go to the inn, which is down. Oh, right, over here. Ooh, what's the inn here called? Sorry, the door is over here. Is this the Origin? Okay, so Origin is a summon in, a very important summon in Symphonia and Phantasia. Generally, Origin's appearance heralds his weapons appearing, like the Origin Blade, or I forget the name of the swords from Origin, but I think it's those two games. He might appear in others, but those are the ones I can think of off the top of my head. Yeah, the Eternal Sword. Thank you. Tabitha is my favorite minor character. She's real good. And we've got we gotta just check a book out? Interesting.
It's a history book titled The Rise and Fall of Midgand. About 800 years ago, our continent was conquered by a military force from another continent. Few records exist of the following 500 years. A period known as the Era of Darkness, or the Dark Period. Then 300 years ago, a great hero named Claudin Asgard reunited the kingdom, bringing an end to the Dark Period.
Claudin, huh? Where have I heard that name before?
All right.
That's enough for today.
Thanks for teaching me, Arthur. Your techniques are so amazing. Where did you learn them?
They came from my own master, a man named Claudin. He developed them himself.
Wow! They're so graceful. I wish I could move like that.
I've taught you the forms, but for some reason your execution deviates from the ideal.
Well, my body just kinda moves on its own.
You're a handful, Velvet. But I will say you do resemble Claudin some. He was a strange person himself. He always wore this peculiar cape, for instance.
Cape, you say?
Deep down, Claudin was strong like fire, vivacious like water, steadfast like earth, and free like wind. I can't help but admire him to this day.
Wow, I'd love to meet him.
Sadly, that's impossible.
Is he dead?
Yes, he is. He died to protect me. That's why I...
No way. The events recounted in this book happened 300 years ago. It can't be the same Claudin.
Velvet, are you okay?
I'm fine. Don't mind me.
King Claudin was quite strong, wasn't he?
He was more than just that. He's the most well-loved and trusted king in our history. Or so the book claims.
To this day, all of Midgan's rulers claim to be direct descendants of King Claudin Asgard. Knowing that, there might be meaning behind them bestowing Arcturus with the grandiose title of Shepherd. I could see it as an attempt to recreate the same glory enjoyed by the Hero King who ended the Dark Period.
If that's true, it's a childish ploy. The world's not so easily changed.
I wouldn't be so sure. What matters is that the title inspires hope in the people, who in turn give him their support. Then, as their shepherd, he can guide his flock in any direction he pleases.
If Arcturus knowingly accepted that title, we can be sure he's fully committed to his cause.
Oh, he's certainly committed. I've seen just how far he's willing to go.
Wait, so Claudin is like 300 goddamn years old? Though, one of the things actually mentioned by that person, by one of the Moloks in Lothgren was that, like, the Dark Age was, like, totally longer than, like... Or he could be named after a famous hero, but that's real-world logic. No, you're right. There's no way. Like... That would be hilarious if it just turned out, yeah, he was just named after the same guy. But, you know. Alright. Alright, it is time. We need to go to the... Zamal Grotto, which is the place we needed to go in the first place, which is good. True, we do have two... That's true. You're all not wrong. We could have two Claudins, because we have two Loffies. Aldina Plains is this way. Alright. Oh, it's raining. That means the dragon's at the peak. One second. Just quick going to refresh a drink. All right. Back. So now that it's, it's raining here, we'll have to go back to where the Dragon's Peak is. We're gonna do that first. Yeah, we're gonna do that first, Zane, don't worry. Again, if Zavied is in the fight, I'll try and let him Mystic. But, who knows. Hey, we're back into like 400 some cat souls, that's good. Good cat souls. Just keep grabbing them. Whew, alright. This has been a side quest building for quite some time, and basically the again, like, kinda culmination of Zavied and Aizen's character in the game. Which is good. Again, both characters we will see, we did see in Zestiria, though neither of them well served in that one. Well, Zavied's actually pretty well served for a while.
Takes me back. I remember the first time I tried to talk to you. You smacked me pretty good then, too. Man, that hurts. You sure don't know how to hold back, do you?
Zavied! Aizen White!
Just watch.
But...
So... You're just waiting for me to die so you can help yourself to her heart. Is that it? Sorry, but that's not happening. I'm not dying here, and I won't let you kill her.
I'll decide what I do, Zavied.
Fine! Then I'm deciding to help Zavied, no matter what you tell me, Aizen. Zavied!
This dragon wouldn't hesitate to attack a child, or the man who risks his own life to protect it. Tell me, Zavied, who is this Whitehorn dragon? You said that your creed was to never give up on living, no matter what may happen. If you really believe that, would you say that you're living right now? Because to me, you don't look like someone truly living.
The hell are you saying?
I understand now. Aizen really isn't the one who's cursed. By killing Theodora, he's actually saving...
It's time to lift this curse.
I'll fight too, to save Zavied and Theodora.
Watch out for the malevolence, Lafayette.
You too, Aizen.
Oh man, this is really good music right here. Again, you fight dragons by standing on their side.
Here,
So this one's actually a little more adept at fighting on the side because it's flying. Here, soul to grab. Yeah, sadly I can't change that here. Otherwise, I would.
You wronged me! Here's your justice! Fighting order!
Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try! Perfect mayhem! Earth, tremble and shake!
No escape, man! No escape! Let's work together!
Help!
Yes! Your soul will clear light! Invigorate us!
Frost!
Twin whip! No escape!
Weak fire. Let me quick change up for fire weakness. Twin whip. Harsh rebuttal. Soaring dragon. Infernal torrent. Or I guess slicing foot, harsh rebuttal. Yeah, oh, you've got a full spin, too. Okay, this dragon is very powerful. Ow. Yeah, spin to win.
No mercy! Wounds I won't heal. Cut into flesh. Lethal pain! Now, rise! Arise! Ascending! Angel!
Killing flash! Behold the arch of my ancestors! Sun gets a child! Aaron!
Here it comes!
Stay back.
Get away from her. If you kill her, if you kill Theodora, I'll never forgive you, Aizen.
I know.
Aizen, how could you? What? Malevolence?
Aizen!
Stay back! This is...
Aizen! Zavied!
No! It'll get you too!
But Velvet, just look at them!
It's that fire again.
Amazing it can extinguish that much malevolence. But the dragon...
Please, turn back to normal! I can do it! With this flame! Zavied!
It's over. Thank you.
Why didn't you break your Reaper's curse?
What? Did you want me to eat its heart?
Don't answer a question with another question.
The Reaper's curse is mine to bear alone. The danger of becoming a dragon, however, is a curse upon all Malakim.
All that malevolence. It's going to take its toll on you, too.
Yeah, I can already feel it starting. It won't be long before I wind up like her.
You'll have to leave your pirate buddies before things turn ugly.
I'm the first mate on Ifrid's ship. So, to be honest, it's probably just as well. I'd rather end up a dragon than have this curse hijack my ship and my life anymore. But I do fear one thing. I'm afraid that when I turn into a dragon, I could end up hurting the very people I want to protect.
Theodora couldn't even recognize anyone she loved anymore. You saved her, Aizen. By killing her. Before all this, Theodora was a kind woman. She never wanted to hurt people, and she loved more deeply than anyone I've ever known.
Yeah.
Sometimes to kill someone is to save them. You have someone you're trying to protect too, don't you?
My little sister.
What's she like?
She's like an early blooming flower. Wise for her age. She's got it all together. Sometimes has to treat me like I'm the kid. She cries too easily. But deep down, she's so strong.
Sounds like someone I'd like to get to know better. Who knows? Maybe I'll even marry her.
Zavied!
Don't you worry. I won't make a move until I've killed you.
Zavied, what are you saying?
Consider it revenge for Theodora. I'll be the one who finally puts you out of your misery. But I'll only kill you once you've stopped being yourself. Only then.
You sure?
Yeah. I swear by my true name, Filk Zadea. Zavied the Oathkeeper.
Ufemiu Wexub. That's my true name.
I'll remember it.
Is there really no other way? There must be something besides turning into a dragon or getting yourself killed, right?
In the end, what matters isn't whether we get killed or not. It's whether we can take control over the direction of our own lives.
That's what it means to really be alive.
That sounds sad. And hard. But I understand. And I'm going to live life in my own way, too.
Well then, I hope we'll see each other again.
Where are you going?
Wherever the wind takes me.
Whatever. Just put those two takes next to each other. Who cares? Just don't worry about it, all right? Yeah, that was something. That was a very good scene. Fuck. That's good. Like, now we have everything. It ties everything together for Zavied's motivation within Zestiria. It fits with Aizen's character completely because of his creed. That was all real good stuff. I liked them trading true names at the end, even if the Wexu or whatever the heck Aizen's true name is just like some, it sounds like some letters. That was all really good. And also handled a lot better than... So, Zestiria has this, like, is Aizen's true name, Dr. Ivo Robotnik. Our true name's just a substitution cipher. Pretty sure that's true, Nilothni. No, Funklemas, that his true name is Kintober. But yeah, that was really foreign. Fuck. I don't know, I liked that a lot. Okay, that unlocks level 4 random skills. Okay, there we go. Okay, I just want to check that. No, okay. However, I have a lot of equipment stuff to do. Fury Piercer goes to... Right, I have the Phonon Blade. Let's go with Topaz. We'll just go up the list. Mithril Belt. Yeah. I'm pretty sure the true names are a substitution cipher. But the trick to it is... The true names are a substitution cipher that was designed for the true names in Zestiria to make sense. Like, specifically for them to sound, like, reasonable. It's how we get Fethless Mioma or Luzrov Roulet. Things like that, or Zavied's there, which was also, again, from... How did I not notice this thunk sound? I like that thunk sound a lot. Runner's High, that's fine. Amphibolic Talisman goes to Exquisite Charm. Imagine the scene in MGS3 where Snake tells Oslo his name is John. whatever. Well, that's because, so, Roses is dumb because Saray made it up. Because Rose's true name means Rose's Rose. Alright, I want to look at a title that I got called Disintegrator. I should look at the, like... Max BG plus one. Ooh! That's a really strong title. I'm willing to give up some stuff for that. BG plus one is super big. Do I have one of those for... I do. I've got Mystic Maestro, which I'm just gonna... Sorry, sounds like a huge idiot, honestly. but Saray's really... I don't know, he's a lot of fun. Again, my enjoyment and love of Saray really comes from... how much I like the fact that he likes ancient ruins. That's a lot of it. Well, no, but seriously, this was really, like, this, I can't stress how good this whole, like, thing has been. I don't know, I'm liking this a lot. Like, this specific Sidequest and how it relates Aizen and, like, how it colors Aizen and Zavied's relationship, which I wouldn't have guessed anything about it from here based on it in Zestiria, so... Alright, so I think let's go to Stonebury. Oblivious, let's... Anything in Stonebury? Oh, check up on the Taliesin family. Alright, we'll do that. We'll do that. Also, I should probably be, like, ending the stream at some point. Do I just want to go do that and end the stream? That's probably good. Yeah. Let's do that. We'll put the capper on the Aizen, side quest, and then we'll come back here next time to start things off. That'll be good, I think. Cats. I too require sleep, and I looked up and thought, holy crap. Before I go talk to that family, I'm gonna go check on one other thing. Don't mind me. Eternal battle. I love it. Something that small makes me so happy. Oh, did I bump into a cat? Oh my god. Oh my god, I was bored. Like, I was like, yep, bored. Ugh. The cat. that's nice. Alright, let's go here.
Oh, it's you! Thank you for everything you've done.
Has Zavied been by since last time?
Yeah, actually, he finally dropped by here the other day. Ah, it was great. We were all really happy to see him again.
What about Theodora?
She wasn't with him, but he made it sound like her problems were finally all resolved.
He said they were going to travel together.
But we don't feel lonely.
Yeah, he said no matter how far apart we are, we'll always be together in our hearts, and they'll never forget us. He told us that we all share a strong bond. And it's all because...
Because that's Zavied's way, right?
Nuh-uh. It's because that's our family's way. All of us.
And it's a wonderful way to be.
Yeah, that's what I think, too.
Zavied told us that because he has family here, because he has somewhere to come home to, he'll be able to travel with an easy heart.
And he left us with a huge pile of money. We told him we didn't know what to do with it all, and he just laughed. He said we could use the money to grow our family even more. If you ever see Zavied on your travels, please give him a message. Tell him... You'll always have a home here. Of course. We'll make sure to pass it on to him.
See ya!
We got orders from headquarters.
They want us to boost security for the transport unit.
But the transport's got more than enough as it is.
A few days back, a Gald convoy got raided. They lost everything, down to the last coin. Thankfully, no one was killed, but the raid was such a clean job, HQ thinks it must have been the work of a pro.
The demons already have us stretched thin enough, and now we have to deal with bandits on top of that?
And Zavied commits a crime. Excellent. All right. I think that's a good end to what we have going on here. So we'll go ahead and save things up. Next time, I have a stop to make in Zamal Grotto, and we have a number of places to go. I'm gonna try to avoid the Empyrean's Throne, but we'll probably go there anyway next time. Also, I guess I don't know exactly when next time will be. It'll be within the next 3 or 4 days. I'll try to make a tweet and such about it like I tend to do. It won't be tomorrow, that's for certain. It will definitely not be tomorrow, I can tell you that much. Tomorrow, I'm gonna be doing a stream with Kavanaugh, which you should all check out. So, yeah, this is, oh man, that was such a good, like, resolution. I'm really happy that, like, Zavied and Aizen get to, like, have their character play out well here. Ugh. So, thank y'all for joining. Y'all have a good night.